the city of DeLand because of its student population and programs that it brings to the community throughout the year. Occupying nearly 200 acres in the city, Stetson and the surrounding area is the second largest call generator for the police department. How will you create a feeling of safety surrounding the campus and downtown area where students frequent, as well as what plans would you have to work with the university and the Department of Public Safety to increase the feeling of a safe campus community?
Partner with the university. The university security should be part of any intelligence sessions that you have. You should remain in contact with them when there's events coming up. If there's something that's going to happen at the university, the police department should be aware, and vice versa. Also, you should utilize the university for recruiting and things of that nature. The university community is, at least in my city, very important as far as the neighborhoods have embraced the students, but there are some unique crime issues that occur as a result of it being a college town. And if you don't remain in contact and share intelligence and things with the university, parents don't feel safe sending their students there. They need to know what crime statistics are and just how safe the city is in general. So mainly share intelligence and work hand in hand with the university as far as the initiatives that you have. Always make them a part.
Land hit it right on the head. It's relationships. You have to establish that relationship with Director Matuzic and Lieutenant Alvindovar. We were actually talking a little bit earlier tonight. It's different when you're policing a campus than when you're policing a community. These are young kids. We've got to talk to them. So the police department needs to be there at the beginning of every semester. We've got a bunch of new 17, 18, 19-year-olds coming in there. And we need to be telling them what's acceptable here in DeLand, and more importantly, what is not acceptable behavior here in our city. We've got these kids that are going to do the same thing that many of us did when we were young, which is make stupid mistakes. They may be coming in here with fake IDs or any number of things that any teenager would do at that age. Okay. But I think that when a police chief or a senior member of the staff meets with these kids early on in the semester and says, look guys, we know you're going to try this, please don't do this. This is what you can get away with here in the city of DeLand. And again, sharing that intelligence with the director and his staff. I think that's really where we need to be.
Now, I respectfully disagree with Mike. I think that Director Matuzic would be invited to be with us on a regular basis when we get intelligence from him and what his needs are for his community. As far as security for his campus, would be his responsibility. I don't think that community should treat any differently than any other part of the DeLand community. They should all have the same amount of service. They should all expect the highest amount of service, the highest amount of customer service. Of course, we'll give special needs to be requesting anything, but I think our goal should be to give all the citizens of the land the highest possible service we can in this department.
Again, it's about relationships and building that relationship with the security force there at the university, understanding what their needs are. I'm a big data-driven guy. I'd like to know what the data is. I mean, second highest of the call service there at the university. What are they specifically? Are the issues that we can assess and analyze and come up with, brainstorm some ideas together collectively to minimize the impact there? I believe a very good idea is to be part of the orientation for the new students, collectively together to decide what information as a university and as a city and the police department that would be disseminated to the young people, and collectively work together on that. I think that's a really good idea. Again, it's just like every other component of the city, it's about relationships, about establishing the vision that you have for that particular part of the city, because collectively it is all one, and working with the security and the university on providing the needs of that university, whether it's education on crime-related issues, trends, and behavior-related issues. issue, whatever we come together and decide, mutually agreeable to discuss. But I think that orientation with the students is a fine time to discuss some of those issues with them. We'll catch some of them and they'll pay attention, maybe not do the things that they don't need to do. But again, relationships, it's all about the relationships and being inclusive.
Well, there's not much left for me to say. I would, I think, establish a monthly meeting with the leadership of the college. I think that's important that we would have open lines of communication. I meet regularly with the school superintendent each month, so it would seem to me if that's the second highest call volume for the city, that then there should be regularly scheduled meetings with the university to see how we can come alongside them and assist them with those issues, if there's anything we can do from the police department standpoint. If the public safety department would be open to it, I don't see a reason why an occasional light patrol couldn't go through the university. Of course, that would have to be at their approval. I just think that, again, the more visible the officers can be all across the city of DeLand, which includes the university, the more relationships they can build, the more transparent the police department will be to them. And it'll be a safer city because the police are engaged everywhere. And we don't discriminate against any section of the city. We provide the best service we can to everyone.
Well, similarly, I agree with the panel up here. Yeah, the intelligence sharing, I think, is critical. There may be calls for service that are going on that sets of security may or may not be aware of. So if we share intelligence on a routine basis, maybe monthly, the various calls for service, provide them with a list of that, then we could possibly identify solutions to problems. I agree wholeheartedly with the relationship building, maintaining a relationship with Director Matusik and Almodovar. And frankly, all the security officers. Our patrol officers should know their security officers and know who to reach out to whenever there's a problem. You may not always have to go through dispatch, but just call up his own officer when he's on duty when there's a problem. Having the officers get out, just like we want to do at elementary schools, and have lunch with the kids, you can do the same during lunch breaks at the university as well by getting out and having positive interaction with the students. And being a part of that community, just like we want to be a part of the rest of the land. And the last thing I want to share is that the orientation part, I think, is critical. I believe it's gone on in the past, where the police chief or a leader in the police department has that upfront communication with the incoming students of what will not be acceptable in the land. And then on the downtown side of that, and the impact it has downtown, is having foot patrol or bike officers in the areas where we know those students